Michelle Glass here. Our job for today is to look at the muscles of the back. Now we can see a few muscles that we did already on the head, namely the occipital belly or occipitalis, and you're seeing a little bit here of the epicranial aponeurosis. We did look at the trapezius on the head and neck model, but notice here you can see it in its entirety. So it does have its origin up here at the occipital bone and also on the spinous processes of these thoracic vertebrae. And then we're seeing that it's going to insert here at the shoulder. So really big. Okay, then we have the latissimus dorsi. Notice these muscles here are going to insert on the humerus bones. And then we have this deltoid muscle of the shoulder. It's coming around to insert here on the humerus. Now the deltoid is responsible for abduction of the arm or abduction of the humerus. And so that means that its insertion point is the humerus. And we can see here that it's originating on both the clavicle and the scapula. Taking a look here at some of our rotator cuff muscles, we have the infraspinatus, we have the teres minor, and we have the teres major. Now the infraspinatus and the teres minor are part of the rotator cuff, but the teres major is not.